our love for science. Actually, I found some things by Hippocrates too. He was already mentioned before by Torello. And the father of medicine said that wherever the art of medicine is loved, there is also a love of humanity. And he also said that natural forces within us are the true healers of disease. And so I would like to talk about the natural forces of healing as reaction to energy-based devices. And in this concept, about wound healing and repair mechanisms, which are induced by radio frequencies or ultrasound technologies. So radio frequency first. Actually, it was already partly discussed by Dr. Neil Walker, but radio frequency is a high frequency electric current, and we all know that this has been very popular lately, and we have really many new technologies, devices coming up, and actually part of our technology that we use, a bigger part is now radio frequency. So it can be monopolar, bipolar, or unipolar, and we are producing heat by these technologies, heating tissue. Now the tissue effect can be different, and we can also treat different targets. So we can treat the epidermis and dermis, but we can also choose to treat our fat tissue. So if we treat epidermis and dermis at 100 degrees, we'll have ablation, at above 55 coagulation, and somewhere between 40 to 55, we'll have a partially reversible damage with stimulation of neocollagenesis. And when we're talking about fat tissue, we know that our fat tissue is heat sensitive. So we can induce apoptosis, fat cell death, by heating and not even to so high temperatures. So we know that if we heat for 1 minute at 50 degrees, we'll get apoptosis, or we can heat for 15 minutes between 42 to 45 degrees to achieve the same effect. So in this way, we can use radio frequency for tissue tightening and rejuvenation, but we can also use similar technologies for body contouring and circumference reduction, and even for the treatment of cellulite. And there are many studies showing us that what our basic science is telling us and what we see in clinics, that they are actually going well together. This is a study showing that if we treat by RF in the dermis to 55 to 65 degrees, we will actually induce tissue tightening and new collagen formation. Very similar to putting a sweater in the dryer, actually collagen, actually protein contraction, and in the same way our collagen will contract due to heat. So, and there is not only new collagen production, but also new elastin, new hyaluronic acid production. And as Chris Zuckery mentioned about fractional lasers, it has been shown that also fractional radio frequency technologies treat, if we treat fractionally at certain areas, so we will have in the first month new collagen formation at the area under the pins or at the area of the needles. But after 3 months, we will have neocollagenesis diffusely all over. And this has been shown in this study that with the same for HSP47, that there is actually diffuse neocollagenesis in the whole area. And here you can see actually here, this is after 1 month and 3 months, so there is diffuse neocollagenesis. And if we want to compare this to what we see in the clinic, we can see that if this is the patient before and after for treatment September 2011, and then when she's coming a year later and she didn't have any other treatments, she looks better than a year earlier. So this effect of diffuse neocollagenesis is a delayed effect, and it takes time to see it clinically. Here again, before, after 4 treatments, and then a year later without any additional treatments. Now, interestingly, fractional radio frequency technologies have also been very effective for acne scarring. and also for wrinkles. But if you want to treat wrinkles with these technologies, you have to be high on the energies and have many, do many treatments. You have to repeat the treatments many times. And when, interesting, when looking at fractional resurfacing by CO2 laser here, and you compare the results, actually the results are not so far apart, even though with the lasers you can get much better or more efficient results. But the difference is also in what is happening directly after. So this is the picture of a patient after fractional RF. She's a bit red, she can put makeup and she can go out. You can't do this after a fractional CO2 laser, for instance. Another point is that when we resurface fractionally, and this is actually an adaptation of a slide presented by Dieter Manstein during the AAD 2 years ago, if we treat 25% of tissue in this way, like here, and compare it to what we do if we treat 25% of tissue in this way, it's a completely different tissue effect. And when we treat fractionally, what we want to achieve is true tissue regeneration, actually scarless healing or healing without fibrosis. And it has been shown that healing without fibrosis may be achieved if the inflammation is mild. So the more inflammation we have, the more fibrosis we will have in tissue. And the question of inflammation was also actually discussed earlier. So also in the wound healing process, the less inflammation we have, the better will be the healing and the more regeneration we will be able to achieve. So if we want to achieve scarless healing, we want low or minimal inflammation after injury, and when there is an appropriate or severe inflammation, there is actually more chance to damage and impair to repair. Now, another interesting article on actually what is happening with our radio frequency technologies is this, actually these two articles showing that after fractional RF, there is a relatively mild MMP elevation of MMP 1 and 3, which are the catabolic enzymes, and relatively a higher expression of MMP 9 and 13, which are the remodeling enzymes. So there is relatively more remodeling and less damage. And what I'm asking is, maybe this is related to the milder inflammatory response after this treatment. So RF, bioremodeling, led to less post-procedure inflammation, less downtime, and had no bleeding after the procedure, and actually there was a predisposition of heating to the extracellular matrix. It led to volumetric heating and thus to tissue tightening and also to a different molecular effect in tissue. So we'll go now over to body contouring. So body contouring is actually